Let's take a house tour. Anybody home? You mind if I stop by?
Sure. Welcome to our home. Yes, I'm wearing pants. This is my demo outfit. I'll leave.
I already did a bad thing.
What?
I put my finger over the lens.
This is the hallway. Very tall ceilings. We'll get a new light.
There. Here's a zoomed out shot. You have quite a tall ceiling in the hallway onto the bedroom.
So this bedroom's really small. We're gonna put a day bed in here, a full-size day bed, because otherwise this giant door won't close. This door is 36 inches. So it's a bit excessive.
And it swings out almost a third of the way in the room.
But we got a good-sized closet. We have the original wood floors. They do have a slight lean over there.
Let's show that.
That's okay.
Not too bad.
I'll put the design for this room on the screen. We're not gonna do much in here. Just paint, new light fixture, and then furnish. Moving on to the dark living room.
Dun, dun, dun.
The first thing you'll notice in here is this teeny tiny little baby window.
Let's zoom in. Look at that.
This is the only window in this living room, which is very unfortunate.
But hopefully we're gonna get a better light, bigger window, and maybe get a little bit more light in this room.
Same floors in here, tall ceilings, which is nice. We have our laundry right in this closet. It's like one of those little baby ones. But this unit, I think this unit is only like 600 or 700 square feet. The upstairs unit is like over 2,000 square feet. Which we can't show you that unit because it's occupied, but we'll show you when it's not occupied. So I'll show you the plans in here. We're gonna take off this ugly peel and stick wallpaper and just make this a classy room.
That's what my students do.
Okay.
So there's a little hallway. This door goes out to the alley. There's a breezeway between the homes, and this is where like the garbage and recycle can sit. We have this little baby closet.
Pantry.
Which is kind of like, it has old stairs. Not that big. To the basement, a little scary down there. The ceilings are like 4.5 feet. Then you step back up, this is the heart of the home.
Is it?
The kitchen. And we're gonna wreck this kitchen today. It has cabinets that are very cheap, definitely worn, never had any liners in the cabinets. And it's these like cheap cabinets that
do that.
The sink is just overmount, and then the counters are laminate with lots of burns in it.
Nice.
So nothing too fancy. We're gonna do a new backsplash in here as well. We might do a full-size dishwasher. We've never encountered a little baby dishwasher
kinda
like this.
Kinda cool.
They kinda did a weird little cabinet.
True.
But that's all gonna be gone. This cabinet is, or this closet's, the water heater. Not up to code.
Ugh! We're getting a new one.
Yeah, we're probably gonna go, they're either gonna get one with a blower or go electric just because it's not vented correctly. We'll hide up those issues. There's a nice little eat-in kitchen area. Good window. The ceilings get a little bit shorter back here, so it's a little dangerous to have a fan here in my opinion.
Yeah.
I feel like you could chop your hand pretty easily.
But all these floors, these are tile.
It's not laminate.
They're fine. It's not what I would choose, but it's fine.
But it was actually laid pretty well.
Yeah.
Like I've seen tile much worse. This is the one bathroom of the house.
With the biggest window in the whole house.
Yep.
Look at that window.
And this is out to like the little breezeway, the alley area. Kind of the smallest vanity that you can get.
Some crust.
Some corrosion, toilet. Love a good crooked medicine cabinet, and I think this is the highlight of the home. These LED bulbs, these things are expensive.
We're gonna keep those.
And then I'll get out of your way. You can see the little shower. You can show them that.
Shower? It is real tile, but you know, everything needs a good scrub.
Yeah.
We'll probably keep most of that.
This is the last bedroom. I'd say this bedroom is just slightly better. Shorter ceilings. Less windows, but it's kind of like a private area because it's kind of built into the hill. So it's very private. It's going to be well insulated. just, this is our only AC cooling in here right now, and the house actually stays pretty cool because it's kind of what's a subterranean home, a hobbit house. This one has the same size closet as the front one. Voila. And then the other little closet is the HVAC, which we're gonna get upgraded. So that's our first project. We just had a guy come out.
Nice.
This is the unit 2 tour.
We will tell you more details about the situation that occurred and why we are now in this, because before there were gonna be people living here. So we'll tell you that inside.
Is this the detention center?
No, this is unit 2.
Okay.
Welcome. Let's go.
Let me first give a...
Unit 1.
That's what we're working with back here.
Unit 1 door to nothing. This was drywalled over, but they left the door. Into our private oasis. We have our garden. Look how much space there is here. Remember, we're in the city. We can grow a whole tree here. We got a pergola with shade. Super private. We have a beautiful view of the church steeple. I'm very excited to have patio furniture out here, pressure wash all the crust away. We have a hose, we have an outdoor light. Get rid of this moldy thing. Have plants. It's gonna be really cute.
What's that?
That's the tenant's trash. That'll be gone too. All right, come on in. We enter into unit 2. This unit is approximately 2,000-ish square feet, probably a little bit more, so it's big. 2.5 bathroom, 2 bedroom. Kitchen, there's a half bath here. Pretty cute, it's a big half bath. Sink, toilet, that's all you need. This is where they did a lot of their smoking. We got this weird pocket door that they put a regular handle on.
Weird.
So it doesn't lock.
I'm gonna stand this way so you can appreciate how big this kitchen is.
Yes.
So right from the entrance of the house, you have a big kind of coat closet.
Scary.
Oh, you can kind of see through it.
So that's nice to have just right here. And then I'd call it a galley kitchen. There's all the appliances, dishwasher, fridge, stove. Look at these really cool cabinets. Like that.
They're a little tricky to use.
They're very high, so I don't know about that. But the kitchen is super great. It has real countertops, all the appliances. We might like switch out the faucet. This is just peel and stick, so we'll probably do like a real tile. It has a pantry.
Which never had one of those before in Baltimore.
It's kind of unheard of. And then it just has like so many storage and like drawers and yeah, it's pretty good.
Look at these handles.
The handles are a bit excessive.
Look how they put them.
So we'll probably switch out to that. But overall, it's like, it's a good kitchen. And I like this unit a lot because it has great natural light. Time is at 4 o'clock and it's still pretty bright. So it also has like a little stool area we can sit. This will probably be where we put a table, either here or there. And that's the plan for in here.
And that's the water heater. This is broken.
Yes, very broken.
And HVAC. We're getting cooling added.
Yes, it's neat. Really hot in here right now. I'm kind of sweaty. Then we got a little hallway with another closet.
Nice.
And it goes back into what will be the living room plus our brand new laundry that we just bought. We'll take off this door and this will be the living room. It's not the biggest living room. It's kind of like, I'd say the biggest downfall of this unit, but still fine size. You can get a couch in here and TV. And
I'll get the other shot.
It'll be good. Pretty. We had an incident with the floor, so we have to fix that. And then this goes into a very large bedroom. How big this is. I think we'll put a king in here. It'll go right here. And then a dresser over there with a TV. It's a very good size, big windows. And it's got closet, and your ensuite bath. So this is a good size bathroom too. Pretty. And they didn't go with like the cheapest stuff. Like that's very ugly. We'll get rid of that. But
not the cheapest vanity.
Yeah.
Actual tiles in the shower.
I wouldn't choose it, but it's fine.
I mean, I wouldn't choose it.
But we're gonna keep it. And just I was gonna show you upstairs.
So this, for context, this is the third floor of a three-story unit. Unit one is all first floor. We just showed you the second floor, and the third floor is very private. So this is where they like to smoke out this window, and it smells a lot like drugs.
Fun. Look at all the residue.
All right, so this room right here, this is gonna be probably an office setup, very big space, and it's like a walkthrough room to the last bedroom of this unit. This house is so fancy, it has its own intercom system. It doesn't work yet. We think it just needs batteries.
Yes.
All right, last bedroom right here. A little bit smaller than the room downstairs, but I mean, still a decent sized room, has its own bathroom. Show that tile work.
Real tiles.
This tile is better than downstairs.
Yeah, I like those tiles. It's pretty, they're very dirty, but yeah, it's a pretty.
Actual glass door.
Decent, yeah. The fact that it has real glass.
The vanity is really small, but.
Not bad.
And it still has its own closet. Closet space can be tough in Baltimore sometimes.
True, decent closet. Yeah. Move your arm. All right.
So how did we get the unit?
So we bought this whole house and they were both occupied, both units when we bought it, but the people downstairs were moving out end of July, I think.
June.
And these people had signed a 2-year lease. So they were gonna be here for another 2 years. And we're like, all right, fine, we'll deal with it.
And they signed it January or February of 2024. So they'd only been here 5 months.
We knew that, we still bought it, whatever. We also knew that when we came and it's like looked at this unit a little bit, we knew they were gonna be an issue because we immediately smelled marijuana.
Cigars.
They were like super messy.
Lots of people that there's only supposed to be 4 adults on the lease, 2 brothers and their wives, and then 3 kids. And there was way more people that lived here other than those people.
Yeah. So we were willing to work with them and like we were trying to make it work. We went over the lease with them. They'd already signed it. It said you can't smoke in the house. It said all the rules, you know, the things that they were doing wrong.
Or anywhere on the property for that matter.
Yeah, you can't smoke anywhere. So we went over that. We warned them. The last people warned them several times. And we told them, if you keep smoking, you'll have 30 days to find a new place to live. So then we proceeded on. We started fixing stuff in here for them. There was like broken window, broken toilet, broken garbage disposal, something else.
Oven handle.
Yeah, and every time we were in here, smelled like smoke. And then we would go down in our unit, unit one, smelled like smoke down there.
And we could actually physically see them smoking sometimes.
Yeah.
So it wasn't like we were just trying to catch them. No, they didn't really hide it too well.
Yeah, so unfortunately, we asked them to leave. They really didn't fight us on it. We just said, sorry, you can't do that here. You have 30 days to find somewhere else to live. And they found somewhere to live in like 2 weeks, maybe not even.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so they moved out today. We got the keys today. And now we will have this unit to kind of fix up and get ready to run it as a midterm rental. But first, we're gonna live here. So at first we were gonna live in unit one. Now we're gonna live up here since we think we'll have unit one ready to rent quicker than this one. Plus mm-hmm. It's nicer to live up here.
More
natural light, more space, backyard area. So we're excited. That's the plan.
Sayonara.